आपने जो भी गाना सुना है वो हर सुबह 8:55 पर रेडियो पर बजता था और ऑल इंडिया रेडियो का यही गाना 1936 से, जी हाँ 1936 से लेकर आज तक भारतीय इतिहास का एक अमूल्य हिस्सा बन चुका है। पर इस ट्यून का नाजी जर्मनी से क्या लेना देना है? इसके कंपोजर थे वॉल्टर कॉफमैन।
कौन है ये?
One of the many Jewish refugees who moved to India, escaping Nazi Germany under Hitler's rule. Kaufmann ka janam Bohemia mein hua tha in 1907. He pursued a PhD in musicology at the German University, par unhone apni degree lene se inkar kar diya because one of his teachers, Gustav Becking, was the leader of a Nazi youth group. Indian music ki agar baat kare, to interestingly, Kaufmann described the first Indian records he heard as alien and incomprehensible. Par unhone haar nahi mani and decided to study Indian music. Kaufmann later wrote, "This music was created by people with heart and intellect. One could assume that many, in fact millions, would be appreciating or in fact loving this music." और फिर उन्होंने राग शिवरंजनी से प्रभावित होकर इस AR ट्यून को कंपोज किया। Kaufmann 1934 में इंडिया आए थे और उन्होंने यहाँ 14 साल बिताए। He also founded the Bombay Chamber Music Society, जो हर हफ्ते विलिंगटन जिमखाना में परफॉर्म करते थे। Kaufmann was part of a trio in which he played the piano, Edigio Verga played the cello, and Mehli Mehta, maestro Zubin Mehta's father, was on the violin. Apparently, Mehta is AIR tune ke bhi violinist hai. Other than being the director of European music for AIR from 1937 to 1946, Kaufmann also worked for Bhavnani Films and the Information Films of India. Wo Mumbai ke Sophia College mein lecturer bhi reh chuke hain. One of his pieces, Anasuya, was called India's first radio opera. He also created music for Indian films like Ek Din Ka Sultan and Majdoor. And Naushad Ali said he also composed the background score for Prem Nagar. Indian music ki study karte hue unhone The Ragas of North India and The Ragas of South India, A Catalog of Scalar Material naam ki kitabe bhi likhi. Kaufmann's contribution to creating a bridge between Western and Indian music is irreplaceable. Eventually, he joined the School of Music faculty at Indiana University in Bloomington. Till his passing in 1984, he never stopped writing and learning about Indian music.